Come on, you fans. Coming up in Chicago, it's going to be a spectacular as never before. The WWF Wrestling Classic. First time ever in Chicago on Thursday night, November the 7th. And it is going to be a 16-man elimination tournament. Not to be confused with the Battle Royal. 16 of the greatest in the World Wrestling Federation will be going in single matches in an elimination tournament. And also, on that very same night, Hulk Hogan, World Wrestling Federation's heavyweight champ, has a title defense on that great, great card. By the way, fans, of course, across the country and around the world certainly know that they're going to have an opportunity to not only see an outstanding wrestling card, but also an opportunity at winning a 1964 Rolls-Royce Silver Cloud 3. It is going to be something else. I know a gentleman that's going to be a big part of an upcoming card is this man. What was that? Macho Man Randy Savage.
Happened so fast you can't even talk about it. Lucky person, yeah, out there somewhere is going to win a silver cloud. What a lucky, lucky, lucky person. And Tito Santana, if you go to the Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship bout with the Macho Man Randy Savage and escape with your life and still lose your belt, you are a lucky, lucky, lucky Tito. Yeah, that's what they're going to be calling you. Because comparatively speaking to the Macho Man Randy Savage, you are nothing but garbage, yeah. Nothing but garbage, Gaina. And I'm talking inevitable, and I'm talking you can't hold that belt with me climbing through the ropes. Gene Okerlund right here is a crying pal. And I want you to give that to Tito Santana. Yeah, because things are just popping right now. Things are starting to cultivate. Things are starting to grow. Things are getting real colorful.
Look at that roll.
Just like the Silver Cloud Rolls Royce.
I'm very
top
curious.
Top of the line.
Wait a minute. Randy.
Tito Santana, comparatively speaking, you are like a grain of sand in the Sahara Desert. Yeah, and I am the entire desert. And the new Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion. Don't bet against me.
I don't bet
anyway. Don't lose your life, no. Don't
what about
change
Elizabeth?
Your life. Elizabeth is icing the champagne right now because the time is getting near and the Guyana must face the match of the century. Yes.
Champagne?
Champagne.
What kind?
Oh, yeah, it doesn't matter. Nothing matters, no. Nothing matters but the Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship belt, which I will own. Oh, yeah, Tito Santana, climb in the garbage can, because comparatively speaking, you are nothing but garbage.
Now, that's a little rough conversation from the
you
Macho Man, but it's kind
sense.
Of true to form as to what he's been saying. Advance, don't miss the big one. Stay tuned for more.
Right back.
He named the official World Wrestling.
I'm not upset. I'm not the one with a headache.
You should be upset.
I'm not the one with seven stitches in my head. I am the manager of the year. As you calculated those votes for me, I won. I don't care what that dumb hillbilly says. I don't care what that loudmouth pig Lou Albano says. I am the manager of the year. Simple, cut, and dry. Now, you want to talk about conditions of people? Albano had seven stitches in his head. They took him to the hospital. They ran a test on his brain. They found nothing. Hillbilly Jim is completely injured inside. Everybody knows the condition of Andre the Giant. Anybody that gets in my way, manager of the year, or stud in Bundy's way, you're going to have to answer to these two gentlemen. And if you don't think that's bad news, you ask the hillbilly and you ask Andre the Giant.
What about yourself? Would you be amenable to putting on the tights and the boots, as they say?
That's what she asked me. It's nobody's business.
Oh, please, give me a break. Yes, Big John Studd, I see you've got that old bag with you again.
That bag of hair. This is like a bag of gold, little man. Everywhere I go, people stop and they notice the stud. You know, every time I get up in the morning, I look in the mirror and I would see the most devastating force in wrestling. But you know, Gene, I thought I saw it all when I saw myself until I saw King Kong Bundy. The most impressive move in wrestling today, the most impressive move in the sport of wrestling is the big splash that King Kong Bundy gives. I've seen two great wrestlers carried out. Andrea,
you know,
carried out with a big swollen
Hillbilly Jim, I know.
And Hillbilly Jim, and it was all from the splash. And my part to it, it's not much. I just grab their legs and hold them down, and I say, jump, Bundy,
You say how high, right, King
Look
Kong?
At the trophy right there, baby. The greatest trophy in professional sports today. You know, Oakland, we've tested that avalanche. We've tried it on men. You see what it does to them. We've tried it on buildings. Small buildings go down like nothing. We've tried it on cattle. We've tried it on everything.
On cattle.
And nothing gets up. On everything. Men, cattle, small buildings. Anything I hit with the avalanche has got to go down. You got the biggest team in professional wrestling. 858 pounds. Bundy and Stud, the unbeatable team, the unslammable team.
Cattle,
with the manager of the year right here, the greatest mind in professional wrestling. Don't worry about it. Take my word for it. We did it. We're the unbeatable team.
822 pounds, the team that can't be slammed. So, Andre, if you want to get yourself in top physical condition, get back in that ring, try it.
How about you?
I'd be glad to get in the ring anytime,
any place. Weasel out of something.
Now, there you go again. I'm not a weasel. I don't know where you're getting this weasel.
What do you hear, weasel?
Call weasel?
I don't know.
Somebody call me weasel.
Ready, Ford Oakland.
How'd you like to test this one?
I got to tell you, you're probably the greatest commentary I have ever seen. We have Mr. Jessi the Body Ventura. What a pleasure it is to have you here on the pit.
Thank you, Roddy. It's a pleasure to be here on the pit. And I just want to say, Roddy, I think some people abuse you out here, and you won't get that problem from me at all.
All right, what a man. And I want you to know something. I watched this last thing on Saturday Night Main Event, that Uncle Elmer getting married, and with what you had some of the best commentary for that wedding I have ever seen in my entire life, man.
Well, I'll tell you something, Roddy. The whole thing made me sick to my stomach. This love and wrestling connection made me sick to my stomach. But I'll tell you what, you know, in my opinion, we shouldn't have broadcast the wedding.
Nothing, man.
We should have did the honeymoon. Can you imagine that?
Ah! Don't you see? I have a live Piper's Pit coming up on Saturday Night Main Event. It's going to be aired tonight, man. That's a live Piper's Pit with the hillbilly, Cousin Junior, the pig, and Uncle Elmer. And I thought to myself, what kinds of questions would I ask him? Because after the honeymoon, I thought to myself, what if there's another Uncle Elmer in the oven? I thought, what a terrible thing!
Can you imagine that? After this honeymoon, there might be, I'll tell you this, Roddy, in my opinion, if there was ever a time for legalized...
You're right. You're right, if there was ever a time, man, there was ever a time for that. You see, you can take the hillbilly, but we got something. Wait a second. Before Uncle Elmer comes on the pit tonight, we have promised we're going to milk him. That way he will only maybe be 350 pounds. What a pleasure it is, man.
Exceptional managers here in the World Wrestling Federation like yourself, but they also have, I believe, something in common with you. They both have very viable tag team combinations here in the World Wrestling Federation. You'll agree with that.
Johnny Valiant has a lot in common with me. He's a great manager, and he manages champions.
A great
Captain
man.
Lou Albano has nothing in common with Valiant or myself or any other person walking the face of this earth.
Except all three of you smoke cigars.
I don't smoke cigars.
Oh.
And I don't interrupt people. Captain Lou Albano puts rubber bands through his face, talks like a jive cab driver, and is nothing more than a smorgasbord slob. Period. I'm manager of the year. Now, you want to talk about some big tag teams? Brutus Beefcake, Valentine, you want to talk about the Iron Sheik, Volkoff?
Mm-hmm.
Take a look at this tag team, pal.
Holy.
Try this on for size.
Oh, yes.
I'm gonna check the full of it.
Yeah, would you please?
You know something, little man?
Excuse me.
I don't like to contradict Bobby the Brain Heenan, but without a doubt, he is the greatest manager of all time because he brought Bundy and Stud together. He engineered the downfall or the destruction of the myth of Andre the Giant when we cut his hair, and then when we smashed him and got him out of wrestling, and then when we brought Bundy in when he tried to get smart with me, and Bundy smashed him and smashed him and smashed him, and then when we took Hillbilly Jim on television and we smashed him and smashed him, and whoever steps in our way, all we're going to do is smash him and smash him.
All right.
Sounds like a law firm, right? Smash him and smash him.
Do we treat him and how? I'm very familiar with that. Yes, sir. King Kong Bundy.
You know, Oakley, we could go on all day. I don't think we should have to stand here and tell people how great this tag team is. The two biggest, most devastating athletes in professional wrestling and the greatest mind in professional sports, Bobby the Brain Heenan. Anybody but the most ignorant being can look at this team and tell you it's the premier tag team, the biggest team, the unslammable team. Andre the Giant learned. He learned the hard way. That's right. That's right. He got that far out of line, and we put him back in line. We put him back there fast. We put him in line. You know something, Over? It doesn't matter. People aren't going to look back and say, well, they did it 3-1. The fact is we did it, and that's all that matters.
You know, little man, you seem to be trying to come between us at all times.
No.
Always forcing yourself
between
us.
I'm trying to play the devil's advocate if I can, Mr.
You know what you're trying to do, pal?
What?
Is stir some trouble. That's all you try to do.
That's not true.
That is true. And don't call me Weasel.
Weasel?
You just called me Weasel.
You
don't call me Weasel. Now, when you talk to these two gentlemen, conduct an interview and do it properly.
I won't call you Weasel again.
What are you talking about?
I didn't say it.
Gentlemen. Fans, thank you very much. John Studd, King Kong Bundy, and
you, Weasel.
Andre the Giant. However, meanwhile, Big John Studd apparently was not intimidated by the presence of Andre.
He was angered by it, and with that anger, he really, really did a number on Sal G.
The winner of this bout, Big John Studd.
Oh, no. Oh, no, don't do that. The match is over. Over! That was done to Andre the Giant in Toronto, Canada. Some time ago, that was the very move, although it was a series of, I believe, four or five slams like that. It actually cracked his sternum.
Yeah, and Andre the Giant, a truly giant like that. Can you imagine what he did to the cell? Gee, my goodness. They were very upset when they saw Andre the Giant. The Stud really took it all out to cell G, and he really, really punished him terribly.
All right, let's go back to the replay. Bobby the Brain Heenan feeling pretty good about himself.
Moment or two. I want to bring in the venerate octogenarian entrepreneur and wrestling manager extraordinaire. He is Fred Blassie, the Hollywood fashion plate, and a man who has been greeted with a great deal of success in professional wrestling as a wrestler and now as the manager of Nikolai Volkoff and the Iron Sheik.
The greatest wrestler in the world is standing right in front of you. The Iron Sheik, the world heavyweight wrestling champion. Still considered the same by yours truly, because the man did not lose his title, he had it stolen from him. And I heard Paul Orndorff get out here crying and moaning about $50,000 bounty. Well, that's what we want. We want money.
I can see you've got money. You've got 16 karat diamond rings. You've got obviously very expensive Rolex watches. Take a look at this. Boy, you've got enough hardware to...
Well, I mean, after all, when you got it, you might as well spend it. I'm not like you. Sit on my money and think you're going to take it with you when you leave.
Not the case at all.
You know, Jimmy.
Iron Sheik. Once again, welcome.
Maybe you're right. Maybe absolutely you're right. Mr. Blassie doesn't really need the money too much. But one thing I needed, that body of the Paul Orndorff. Because Paul Orndorff come here begging and crying, somebody going to beat him up sooner or get the money. I'm not money hungry, but I'm hungry for that body. Beauty. Anywhere we go, the American girls, American boys, they're cheering for him. Call it USA, USA. He reminds me another Hulk Hogan. Now.
You know, you should really respect, though, the old country businessman, because they say make the money and hang on to it. Make it go.
Somebody, I'm thinking about that body. I'm not money hungry. The Sheik have A to the Z. But Paul Orndorff is different than the two. My body
man,
and your body.
Right,
I could love him there.